be honest with your heart this morning. If Jesus was to come today, would I?
That's right.
Thank you.
Would I really be ready to go?
Right.
Thank you. Not everyone that says, Lord, Lord, shall enter in, but he that doeth the will of my Father.
Yes.
God is looking for a bride. Divorce rate is down, as I said the other Sunday morning, because marriage is down.
That's right.
People don't want to commit no more. They want to shack up and try it out.
That's right.
Trying to parallel marriage. Well, you don't buy a car unless you drive it, do you? Oh, I'm here to tell you, so morally unclean and mentally unstable. Huh?
Right.
But I'm here to tell you, Jesus is not looking for someone to shack up with.
That's right. That's right, amen.
To just have an occasional date. He wants you to become his bride.
Amen.
Part of the church that is redeemed. Bought with a price.
Amen.
I love him, preacher. You know what? I told my wife I loved her, but I really didn't start loving her until we really began. That's the truth. We say we love. That love is so, words so empty. Young people say, I love you, and they haven't been with each other a month or two. I love you. They don't know. They don't know what love is. You try to tell them that, and they just, you stupid. You don't know what you're talking about. I mean, to tell you, love does not vaunt itself. Huh? It's not puffed up. Amen to God. Love will go the extra mile. Lover says, you know what, I love you if you have both your legs cut off.
That's right.
Lover says, I love you if I got to feed you with my hands the rest of my days.
Right.
Lover says, I love you so much I'll die on the cross even though you might not receive me.
That's
how much I loved you.
Hallelujah.
And all he wants is love in return.
That's right.
We're wounded, we're naked, we're crippled, and he still wants to love us.
Yes.
Woo! That's something to thank you. Let's all stand this morning. I come to Christ wounded, crippled, sin sick, but he loved me right where I was.
Yes.
Kind of like when David told Bathsheba that you can eat at the king's table. Lame because his nurse dropped him.
Yes.
He said, what am I that you would pay such attention to a dead dog as me? All that your father had, I'm going to restore back to you all his lands, but you're going to eat at my table. I don't know about you, but I come in lame, sick, and full of sin, but he loved me right where I was.
Yes,
and set me at his table and nourished me.
God.
All God wants is you. I don't know why folks just won't come to God and sell out to God. Because I promise you, this world that has so much pull is coming to an end. It's coming to an end. Swiftly and fastly, in the God of this world, the devil's blinded people's minds, though they can't see a need to sell out to God. For so many people are going to be left behind because they were not committed to God. My name's on the roll, preacher. I've been baptized. That don't mean nothing. I promise you, God's role is not in conjunction, in agreement with the church's role. God wants to put your name on his role tonight, this morning. Wash you and cleanse you. Don't you want to become the bride of Christ? Don't you want to be ready when Jesus comes? For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, the trump of God. The dead in Christ shall rise first. And we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together in the air. Amen. To meet the Lord in the air, so shall we ever be with the Lord. What a comfort to you those that have been married to him for a long time and have been faithful. Comfort you one another with these words. Preacher, I've been staying in his life because I know he wants a bride, not a date. For those of you that haven't made that commitment and that intimacy, have given it all to God, being washed in the blood, these altars are open this morning. Will you come? As she sings, will you come this morning? Say, preacher, I'm coming today. Savior. I want to be part of the bride. I just don't want to date him. I want to know him. So you come this morning. He loves you. He's calling you. All you've got to do is come. What's holding you back? What's the reason why you don't? Is it going to be worth not falling in love with Christ and marrying him? He says, I'm married to the backslider. He calls, he woos, he pleads. Come! Because I'm coming to catch my church away. She'll be caught up together. What I pray everyone here would be part of the bride of Christ this morning.